indoor vertical farms have been touted for their ability to grow leafy green vegetables like lettuce in warehouses year-round. Bowery Farming, one of the U.S.'s largest vertical farm companies, says it can grow more than 5.5 tons of produce daily. And in a bid to expand its portfolio, the company is adding a new crop to its roster, strawberries. About 90% of strawberries in the U.S. are grown in California. The state's strawberry harvest runs from early spring until fall.
Because we're grown close to the point of consumption, we can pick these berries at the peak of freshness, and then they're on shelf 48 hours later.
With strawberries, it takes more steps because the leaf has to grow, as does the flower, and the flower that becomes the strawberry fruit actually has to be pollinated. So these companies have to enlist the help of bees to pollinate those flowers to ultimately become the fruit that people will eat.
Vertical farms like Bowery use a mix of sensors, robotics, and automation to grow food that they say makes their produce fresher, better tasting, and better for the environment. But vertical farms also face challenges, including a significant upfront investment in the use of extensive lighting systems that are energy intensive. In 1935, there were 6.8 million farms in the U.S. By 2020, that number dropped to a little over 2 million. So with the global population expected to surge to about 10 billion in the next 30 years, and with the vast majority of those people living in urban areas, can indoor vertical farms like Bowery be a viable alternative for growing the world's fruits and vegetables? In a warehouse in Kearney, New Jersey, outside of New York City, Bowery's indoor vertical farm stacks crops from floor to ceiling, using LED lights to mimic the sun and the continuous supply of water and nutrients to feed its plants. Crops like lettuce and arugula are grown year-round.
In addition to the genetics piece, right, the seed piece, within our system, the variables that we play with are nutrients, light, airflow, and light, it's not just the intensity of light, but it's the photo periods. We could make a 28-hour day for our plants, right? Or a 16-hour day, depending on what we think the optimal recipe is.
It has other benefits too. Bowery claims its vertically stacked design can yield 100 times more produce compared to an outdoor operation on a similar footprint while using 95% less water. The company's crops are grown without pesticides, and different types of plants can grow side by side. Indoor farms also don't have to contend with seasonal labor shortages like on traditional farms. And growing crops closer to your customer allows goods to be shipped from harvest to shelf in as little as 48 hours. But indoor farms face significant challenges, including hefty startup costs, high urban rents, and steep energy costs to power LED lights and ventilation.
In general, it's still in the very early stages. A lot of the companies that consumers see on shelves are pretty limited in what they can grow. It's a lot of different types of lettuce. But I spoke to a vertical farming expert, and she was saying, you know, people can't live on salad alone. These companies need to branch into other crops. And some of those crops, like berries, not only are they more complicated, they also are pricier.
While low-growing crops like leafy greens have been the hallmark of vertical farms, fruits and berries have been harder to develop. But that's starting to change. In 2022, Bowery launched a limited-release pack of strawberries at select New York City retailers. Strawberries grown on traditional farms generally have to be shipped long distances, which diminishes their taste. Strawberries also rank annually at the top of the Dirty Dozen for fruits that contain the most pesticides. To further enhance its berry production, in 2022, Bowery purchased Traptic, a robotic company that uses 3D cameras and AI to harvest fruit and vine crops like strawberries and tomatoes.
And the good thing for these farms is if they crack how to grow those berries, they also can help drive up profits for their business, potentially by selling higher value fruits and vegetables.
Bowery Farming got its start in 2015. In 2021, revenue doubled. It works with retailers, including Whole Foods and Walmart, and has farms outside of New York City and Baltimore. It also has plans to expand. And that expansion could be good for the industry as a whole if it finds consumers are willing to pay for produce that tastes consistent no matter the season.
The possibilities are endless, right? When we're talking about genetic diversity and biodiversity of seeds, our system allows us the agility and flexibility to experiment with all these different types of seeds.